So this lecture is totally about phylogenetic analysis. We will discuss few of the key components of phylogenetic analysis and tree construction. Phylogenetic analysis is basically the study of evolutionary development of a species or group of organisms or a particular characteristic of an organism. And to construct a phylogenetic tree, mostly DNA or protein is used. To get a DNA or gene sequence, we can get it from NCBI, from gene database. We can search for any gene we want, such as BRCA2 or one for Homo sapien. Similarly, we can search on ensemble. So this is Homo sapien gene. We don't want all the theoretical data. We only need the sequence to construct a phylogenetic tree. So here in the sequence tab, we can get the sequence of gene. Simply we can download it in FASTA format, but this sequence is too long and it will take time to generate alignment and phylogenetic tree. So protein is used for phylogenetic tree construction most of the time. The reason is rate of mutation in DNA is higher than protein. Mutation can occur in a DNA sequence in gene during transcription and translation, but rate of mutation is protein is compared to DNA is less. And also the protein sequence is of much shorter length as compared to DNA. The alignment of protein and tree construction will be much faster and accurate as compared to DNA. So to get a protein sequence, we can use UniProt database and search for any protein and the target protein we need to construct a phylogenetic tree. And we need multiple sequences because we want to compare it with other proteins to get an evolutionary relationship between them, such as ligase enzyme. So this will give ligase enzyme in different species, different organism. We can compare it between the organism, between the species, such as we can see this one is of human Homo sapien, and this one is of rat, mouse, and then human again. So all the ligase sequence it has for different organisms, and we can search on any entry we want and get a protein sequence and download in FASTA format. So here we can see it's the sequence. We can download it. The FASTA format. This is the FASTA format starting from greater than sign and then the name. This is the protein ID. This is the organism and complete name of the protein. This is for Homo sapien. And this is the complete sequence of protein. We can see this is of much shorter length, about 760 amino acids as compared to thousands of nucleotides in the gene sequence. To save time and speed up the process, I have already created the file. You can simply create file by copying this text into the Notepad text file. So I will use my text file which I have created already. So after copying 5 or 10 sequence, the file will be like this. It will contain a complete information and description of the protein, then protein sequence, then description of another protein, its sequence, and so on up to 5 or 10 sequence, or up to as many sequences as we want. We can use different softwares, some online available and some are offline, such as MegaX or Genius Prime. For this tutorial, we are using MegaX software to construct a phylogenetic tree. But first we have to refine our sequence. So we don't need this long description of the protein here. We only need the protein sequence. To refine a sequence description, we have to delete unnecessary details. One thing we can do is by using only protein ID if we want, or we can specify proteins by alphabets A, B, or C, or 1, 2, 3 as we want. I have only used a strain name as it was of a bacterial sequence. I will use only these proteins to construct a phylogenetic tree. This 27 file is we are using to construct a phylogenetic tree. When we paste a sequence in a text document, .txt file is generated, but we need to convert it into FASTA format. There are different methods to convert it into the FASTA format. The most easiest method is by enabling the file name extension and then rename it by removing .txt into .fasta. This will automatically convert text file into FASTA format. Import this FASTA format into our MegaX file. Open a file session. Here I can open this FASTA format into our MegaX. So when I open my FASTA format, I prompt this message. I want to align the file or want to analyze the file. Sure, to construct any phylogenetic tree, first we want alignment. These are multiple sequences, so it will automatically align this by multiple sequence algorithm. This is the result after alignment of proteins. In case of gene or DNA, as the nucleotide of thousands of base pair long, so it will take much longer time to align gene sequences as compared to proteins. So this is the aligned file of all the proteins I had. So this was the basically FASTA format of my protein. And now I need to export this alignment as mega format in order to construct a phylogenetic tree and save it in the same folder. It will ask me to change the name. So mega file has the extension of .meg. This is the title of the data. Okay. I need to close this file and now open again the mega file. So open a session again, just like we did for FASTA format. This time we are choosing mega format and open. This will automatically open the aligned protein sequences. And here we can see this is the sequence result. These are the six proteins that we have aligned using MegaX. And here we can construct a phylogenetic tree by clicking on phylogeny and selecting the required tree algorithm. Construct maximum likelihood, neighbor joining tree, UPGMA. These are all the phylogenetic tree with different algorithms. One of the most popular tree construction method I am using is neighbor joining tree. Yes, I want to use the currently active data, which is the mega file. Okay, phylogenetic tree is constructed. Here we can see all the proteins that were aligned with the mega file with different branches and a brief description about the tree. The evolutionary history was inferred using neighbor joining method that I choose to construct this phylogenetic tree. The optimal trees with the sum of branch length is equal to 0.1427. This is the sum of branch length as we have different branches in the tree. If we sum all the branch length, it will give the result 0.1427. The tree is drawn to scale with branch length next to branches, the same unit as those of the evolutionary distances used to infer the phylogenetic tree. After tree construction, we can play around with the tree, such as we can change it into straight or curved. Also, we can use radiation or cycle tree. So we can see this is the close, and this protein over here is the distance relationship. It is the outgroup. One thing that we can do is we can save this as PDP file, BMP file, or PNG file. To save this tree as an image file with higher quality, we use PNG method and select a file name. This is the path, and this is the file name, and .png is the extension of the file. Okay, and this tree, the circular format, is saved in the directory. We can zoom in and out. We can search for a particular taxa. We can simply give a taxon such as EARPUN. So it highlighted the EARPUN. Here we can resize the tree and focus on the branch that we required. So this was the basic introduction to MegaX tree construction. To recall all the steps, first, we need a protein sequence that we can download from UniProt. And then step one is to convert the text file into FASTA format by changing the extension .txt into .fasta and then import the text file into MegaX and choose align. After alignment file is generated, we have to go to data and export this alignment into .meg format, that is mega format. and then close the FASTA file and open mega file. This is the mega file with the aligned result. We can construct the phylogenetic. Here we selected the neighbor joining tree for currently active data and click yes. The phylogenetic tree will be constructed. The lines in the tree are called branches. At the tips of the branches are sequences known as taxa. So these are the branches, and at the tip of the branch, these are sequences of protein that is known as taxa. And singular of taxa is taxon, or operational taxonomic unit. The connecting point where two adjacent branches join is called a node, which represent an inferred ancestor of extant taxa. The two taxa share a unique common ancestor not shared by any other. So we can see here these first two taxa that share this unique point that is not shared by any other. These two are the sister taxa, as they bifurcate from a single root, single parent, and have the common ancestor. As this was an unrooted phylogenetic tree, so unrooted phylogenetic tree does not assume knowledge of common ancestor, but only position the taxa to show their relative relationship. Because there was no indication of which node represent an ancestor, there is no direction of an evolution. There is no direction of an evolutionary path in an unrooted tree. To define the direction of an evolution path, a tree must be rooted. So there are two ways to define the root of a tree. One is to use an outgroup that we have talked about, which is a sequence that is homologous to the sequence under consideration, but separated from those sequences at an early evolutionary time. Here EKRPON is the outgroup with a score of 0.0531, and other are in-groups. Outgroups are required to be distinct from the in-group sequence, but not too distant from the in-group. Distinct means it is unique from other sequence, but not too distant. If it is too distant from the in-group, it will be hard to analyze the sequence. Using two divergent sequences as an outgroup can lead to errors in tree construction. And in the absence of a good outgroup, a tree can be rooted using the midpoint rooting approach, in which the midpoint of the two most divergent groups just by overall branch length is assigned as the root. This type of rooting assumes that divergence from root to tips for both branches is equal and follows the molecular cloth hypothesis. So this was the basic introduction to phylogenetic tree and how phylogenetic tree can be constructed using MegaX software and using the different protein sequences from UniProt database. If you want to know more about the theoretical knowledge of phylogenetic analysis and phylogenetic tree and different types of tree, you can read it on Essential Bioinformatics books. I personally read this book to understand different bioinformatic key concepts.